Okay. This one's Poundtown. Just outside of London, a group of obese people run a kill shelter in this daily two-hour dramedy.
Daily two-hour
it's
dramedy?
It's on every day.
When the money is tight and the dogs are gone, what will Mr. and Mrs. Pound do for money and food?
That could be an interesting one.
So this is called Shallow Drowning. Follow three ministers as they set off on a pilgrimage to bring faith to a sinking island. The residents are cannibals, and the ministers are chubby, and the tide is rising.
Okay. Sounds awful.
It sounds awful.
Just from an interest standpoint, people know what it is. That's something they're going to watch.
What?
Somebody get eaten this week. How far is it going to sink? Maybe it'll sink this week while we're watching.
All right, I'm up. Tickle Me Timbers. From executive... That's just the title, gets me every time. From executive producer Chuck Schartz, Tickle Me Timbers. Tickle Me Timbers is so funny. Tickle Me Timbers is an imaginative reinvention of a Somali pirate hijacking Captain Phillips. Each episode, we see pirates taking a new ship and breaking hearts as they break all the rules. Tickle Me Timbers.
That sounds the best out of all the ideas so far.
All right. Okay, bud, you're up.
This is, Hola, Mommy, where are you? Alice is a savvy businesswoman who is too busy for a relationship. Mike pretends to be a gay, blind Puerto Rican man in order to get close to Alice. The woman of his dreams.
That would work.
Yeah, that works.
Make the
All right, if you like that, you're gonna love In the Doghouse. A former salesman with an eating disorder has his life ruined when his foreign wife can't stop bringing home Bichon Frises and spending money, driving him into madness and murdering in this harrowing drama.
This sounds like
my life.
I'll probably watch it. Is it a comedy?
Make no mistake, there's nothing funny about this one. This is just straight up drama. You're up. I don't want to take all the time.
It's called Chillin' with Mr. Broadway, and it's a multicam comedy which brings Morgan Freeman back to series television as a mythical and mystical Lord of Broadway. Each episode deals with.
Continue.
God, it's great. Each episode deals with the Lord of.
Lord of.
Wait for it.
He's gone.
Each episode deals with the Lord of Broadway's ever-growing harem of chorus girl and choir boys, in which he secretly controls New York City's financial nucleus.
That makes no sense.
You know what? I think that would work, especially with Morgan Freeman.
Morgan Freeman, you can't beat
him. I mean, Morgan Freeman's played those kind of roles the last 20 years.
So if you had to pick one, who would you say has the more marketable ideas?
I'm gonna go with yours.
I feel like I liked more of yours.
Mine? Okay, tiebreaker, yours.
Me.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, wow. Oh, you got one.